Hi, my name is Jen Hammock. I work with the Species Pages group at the Encyclopedia of Life. The Encyclopedia of Life, which has a website at eol.org, is a venue for biodiversity information. We aggregate information of any kind, images, videos, audio clips, text articles, also structured data, for example, body size or flower color, on every species on the planet. Well, there's a lot of biodiversity information available online already, but there's two or three things that it's nice to have the Encyclopedia of Life for. One of them is for the underrepresented species. There are a lot of species out there, a lot of birds and charismatic animals that there's plenty of information for. And if there happens to be an obscure taxon that is not currently of interest to anyone, it can be hard to find information. And it turns out that's the vast majority of species on the planet. There are about 2 million of them, and people are interested at any given time in only a fraction of those. So EOL is trying to fill the gaps in case someone becomes interested in these later because interests shift, other taxa become important. We want to be ready, especially in light of global climate change and other things that are going to bring different new neglected species into prominence or importance of some kind. The Rubenstein Fellows are a fabulous group of people. They come from all over the world. The majority of them are biologists, and the first several cohorts were experts in particular areas of biodiversity. They would have a family of beetles or all the frogs from a particular region would be their area of interest. And they spent time working with that group to assemble information on it and make it available on EOL. Many of them spend extended periods in various countries that require visas and other paperwork. And honestly, the administrative effort needed to support that kind of cohort at any given time makes the whole concept of the program almost not feasible, unless you have a partner who is experienced in that area and knows how to cope with serving this population. So in that sense, basically, our partnership with CRDF enabled us to have this program.
I've been working at CRDF Global on the EOL portfolio for about 4 years now, since 2010, and I really enjoy working with all the international fellows. It's really interesting for me to learn about their research throughout the world. At CRDF Global, our mission in the EOL portfolio is to assist the EOL fellows financially and also with their research collaborations abroad. Really, in the Encyclopedia of Life portfolio, there are a lot of challenges logistically when we try to assist the fellows with their travel from, say, Venezuela to South Africa. And it's very challenging for us to work with our agencies and all of our banks to ensure that the fellows make it there safely and also have funds to use on their trips.
Repositories of different kinds of information are only making it easier to share information across borders, and international projects are proliferating all over the place. So EOL is basically trying to be a good player in that landscape, keep people informed and keep connected to people who are busy and being productive in that space. So the people who are sharing distribution data on biodiversity, those are important partners. People who are sharing trait data for particular groups and would like to have it disseminated more widely, it's important to aggregate their information. So working with multiple partners, which each can be spread over several countries, is going to continue to be an important challenge for us. It's been a really great omen for what's possible going forward in a world of big data and open data, and making everything accessible to 6 billion people who all have an interest in biodiversity. So we're really excited about that.